Hello and welcome back to HWL Radio Sports. I'm here with the co-host,
Tony Evans from Don't Stop Corporation, guys. It's Monday, April 2nd. Y'all know what time it is. It's National Championship Day, college basketball.
Hey, look. And I was going to cancel. Hey, I was going to cut you off and say, that's all we need from you here. And then, because I was like, man, if Mississippi win, we're going to make the whole show about Mississippi, but they got took out.
About you too.
They got took out by though. Kobe.
They almost.
The female Kobe Bryant.
Yep. It's a big show today. The national championship game, Villanova versus Michigan. We know what happened Saturday. Villanova smashed Kansas 95-79.
Damn.
Ready for this one?
Mm-hmm.
Out of three pointers, 18 out of 40, almost 50%, they would shoot. They set a record. It was a Final Four record. They needed just 7 threes to set a Division I record for the whole season. They set a record. 13 threes was the record in the NCAA game. They had 13 threes by halftime. Mm. So, yeah. And I knew it was going to be a rout, though. When the score was 22-4, I knew Kansas was in trouble. Man, they just got – you're talking about six guys, potential NBA right now. You got Pascal. You got Jalen Brunson. You got Miles Bridges, you got Spellman, and you got DeFizio. Those guys often go play the NBA right now. It's hard to beat that team right now, man. I mean, that's one of the teams I did pick for the championship was Villanova.
Yeah, you said they got. You said they got how many All-Stars?
Six.
Man, so that's well, I don't know. You said UConn had three, and man, Notre Dame they took. Matter of fact, guess what? I took out of the win. The good come with the bad. I lost my money on Mississippi. Then I found out Notre Dame's in Indiana. So
yeah,
I didn't know how to feel.
No, you didn't. Remember you said Notre Dame could sneak in there. You said that last week. I thought about it. So you was winning both games. You picked Mississippi, but you said don't call Notre Dame out.
Yeah, because they always been the fighting Irish.
So I gotta give you credit due. Because you said, no, I counted them out against UConn. I did. I was wrong. I was there wrong. You said don't count them out. You said they can sneak in there. So, you know, that girl hit
They snuck in there and they took out my team. No, just saying.
But you know what? I'm going to tell you what hurt your girl. What hurt Mississippi is when...
Foul trouble.
Foul trouble. But Tierra McCowan, the superstar, the big girl, she missed that layup with 27.8 seconds to go.
That's what I said.
And that hurt it. And also, they gave Notre Dame the biggest comeback ever in women's college basketball since it started in 1982. Biggest comeback ever in a championship game.
And guess what? It fits their name, the Fighting Irish.
The Fighting Irish. They sure was fighting.
They fought their motherfucking way all the way through to the championship.
Yep, second championship they won. And the superstars, you got the most outstanding player, Arike Akinkobawe.
Yeah, go ahead. You say her name because I sure wasn't going to fuck it up.
It's a retake on Gubawe. And she's tough, man. She's tough.
She's going to be in the WNBA.
Without a doubt. She's a pretty shooter.
Tierra's still going to get there, too, though.
Well, you got Jackie Young. She's tough, too. She's a sophomore. She can play one more year and she come back, or she might go to the league early. I don't know, but she'll be a superstar in the league, too. She's out of Princeton, Indiana.
Vivian should be okay, too, though.
Oh, yeah, Vivian's good, too.
And then it's the coach's daughter on Mississippi. Man,
yeah, yeah.
She got a three out this world. They lucky.
She's good. She's real good.
But you got to give Notre Dame credit. They kept them off of that three-point line for majority of the game. That's what really killed them.
Mm-hmm. But Notre Dame, when Kyle and your big girl missed that shot, I said, oh, man. This day, if she hit that shot, they sealed it. The game's over. But it's they won it. They deserve it. Be ready for next year.
Mm-hmm.
But tonight, guys, if you want to watch an NBA team who plays similar to the Golden State Warriors, they pass the ball on the outside, they shoot the three well, they well coach, they get up and down the court.
Look at
Villanova. Every asset against Golden State Warriors. I've been telling y'all from day one when I went to the game against Butler right here December 14th. I told my buddy, he said, Villanova is not that good. I said, I let them pray that she better watch out. I said, Butler won that game. They upset him. I said, listen, I'm not cutting my ass off of Villanova. Hands down, the best team in college basketball. Seriously. They're going to blow Michigan out tonight. There ain't going to be no contest.
Man.
Watch what I tell
you. So who the Michigan, they got, you said they got five all-stars.
Michigan got
six all-stars.
Villanova.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That means they got five starters and one coming off the bench.
Right, exactly. They got six players who can play right now in the NBA, right now, any team, guaranteed. All can play in the NBA. Michigan got, they play off a guy named Mo Wagner. He's tough. He's from overseas. 6'8", shoot the ball well. He got 24 points and 15 rebounds Saturday against Loyola. He's tough, but they need some more firepower, though, because right now, the way Villanova hitting the boards, it's going to be tough to beat them. Not just three-pointers they shoot. We already can shoot three, but they're just hitting the board so hard right now. But tonight, a lot of people are going to be watching their game, too.
All right, so for the bettors, now, on the spread, what do you got the point spread?
I think I take Villanova in 10. I take them in 10. 10 points. 10 points. I give them double figures. 10 points.
And who you think going to be the MVP of this game? Out of the six
MVP
all-stars.
I'm going to give two choices. It's going to be Jalen Brunson or it's going to be Pascal. Pascal is number four. Number four for Villanova, number one for Villanova. Brunson or Pascal? Pascal, I watched him against Butler back in December, and I had told my buddy, I said, unbelievable. This guy should be as strong as an ox, jump out the gym, and he did it. Saturday, he got 24 points. Saturday, he was a leading scorer Saturday.
Uh-huh.
He let me, everything I say he was, he lived to the potential come Saturday.
Yeah, but,
I mean, everything.
But before we close this show up, we're going to just add the cherry all the way on top. Because despite my team losing, my other team been winning in the NBA, the Cleveland Cavaliers. And you know where I'm headed, right?
Yeah, I know. I already know.
Uh-huh. He done passed up Michael Jordan again.
Yeah, he did. He showed it with the streak. Yeah, with the double figure streak, yeah.
Yeah, so how you feel about that now?
I said enough. I got to give him his props. That was a hell of a streak. 856 points. I mean, 856 games. That's a wonderful streak.
Yeah, fuck the streak. I'm talking about, is he better than Jordan yet? In y'all heads or the Jordan fans?
I think he is. I mean, I'm not saying that because you saying that we're on the show together. I think he is. Because he proved it. Like I told you, and people say, why? They probably think I'm talking crazy. Because like I said, I'm going to say it again. I want everybody to hear this. On the 12th and 13th year, Michael Jordan started to decline. As Mike and LeBron James' 15th year, he's still going strong. That's why. Michael Jordan was on a decline. 13 years, he started fading away. You can see his plan. He started to go down.
And I also wanted to, just while we're here, I just wanted to add, I did change up my top three, and I put Anthony Davis. If I'm going statistically, I put Anthony Davis ahead of Harden. It's LeBron, Anthony Davis, then Harden.
Because
I was looking at the stats, and Anthony got him on stats.
Okay.
Might not got him on wins, but he got him on stats.
Okay. Well,
that's going to be the show for today, so go ahead and shoot your shot.
Guys, again, have a great day. Be good to yourself and be good to others. And don't forget, big national championship game tonight. Thank you.
All right, and there you have it. Another good show at HWL Radio Sports. Go over to HWLRadio.com, download the music app. Also go to YouTube, look under HWL Radio Sports. Like, share, subscribe. And we're going to keep y'all up to date on the sports every day, Monday through Friday. And like I always say, hit my motherfucking music. And we out.